I'm so relieved to have found you. I fear my upcoming meeting is going to be disrupted. Strike breakers, maybe, or police spies. Ruffians who fear the march of progress.
Huh. So I'm bodyguarding them. Marvelous.
I worry that any agitation will incite terrible violence, so please remove troublemakers without attracting any attention. Wunderbar. Thank you. I must prepare, but I will see you inside shortly. Workers, comrades, thank you for your most generous welcome. I come before you today with a heavy heart. England stands at the head of commercial and industrial Europe. In the last two decades, there has been an unheard of development of industry and unprecedented increase in exports and imports.
Generous welcome. I come before you today with a heavy heart. England's in the last 2 days.
Gentlemen, united workers! The man we're here to see needs
In the last two decades, there has been an unheard-of development of industry and unprecedented increase in exports and imports. While these are facts to be celebrated by the property classes, for the workers, very little has changed. You well know under what conditions of shattered health, damaged morals, and spiritual power was produced for the upper classes by the working class. It has become a truth that no perfecting of machinery, no application of science to industry, no improvement of the means of communication, no new colonies, no immigration, no opening out of new markets, no free trade, and not all these things
will guts you like
away the misery of the toiling masses.
Looks like trouble is brewing.
What's happening here?
Considered right in the relations of private persons, shall be recognized as the supreme law governing labor in this country. The struggle for such a policy is embraced in the universal struggle for the emancipation of the working class. And so I say to you, has to bring every possible obstacle in the way.
Stay here. I'll deal with this. It can never be easy, can it?
Service for the workers of London. I'm confident the reforms we seek cannot be far over the horizon. I don't suppose you'd formally join the Workers' Party?
I'm not much for politics.
He's not much for anything that requires deep thought.
Does that mean you'll join, Comrade Evie?
I'm afraid I have other responsibilities.
Honorary memberships, perhaps.
You don't give up, do you?
We seem to have that in common. Auf Wiedersehen, my friends.
I'll be right here if you change your mind. Come, look at my wares! Something will definitely be of interest.
No good will come of that.
Yeah! That's the way.
Mr. Frye, I told you to make an appointment.
My schedule was open.
You're fortunate I like you.
Internal combustion engines.
8 small syllables that mean a great deal of money. The engines will be delivered to Milner by train. Secure them for me, and he will be devastated.
I'll need a second train to pull this off. And I think I know just the man.
So we have a deal, Mr. Frye?
You're fortunate I like you, Miss Attaway.
So, what do you want, Frye?
What makes you so sure I want something? Perhaps I saved you out of the kindness of my own heart. Come on, let me tell you about the job.
Milner's pulling a lot of cargo there.
Just be sure to make the transfer.
Give him hell.
Thank you.
have all day. Get cracking!
This one. Internal combustion engine. The end of horse-drawn transport. It's like gazing into the future.
And what is the going rate for the future, do you think?
We're not selling them.
You're giving them to your contact?
You'd be paid all the same.
Who is this Pearl, anyway? How long have you been working with her?
She's a business partner. That's all you need to know.
Didn't make it tea, laddie da. Slap some gold leaf here and there. I gave the wood a splash of shellac. Upholstered the lot. And how do you like the lampshades?
A letter? For me? A dinner invitation.
And with whom are you dining this evening?
Maxwell Roth.
The leader of the Blighters? You're not going.
Of course not.
Good day to you, Jacob.
Excellent choice. Hope to see you again. John Paul wages the to keep in a gentleman's
Wake up. Not very good at hiding, is he?
I wonder what he's up
to. Heads up! We have an intrusion!
You blighters, do away with this nuisance.
Give them a good
place.
on, help!
My word!
I found a body!
Bloody
what do I do?
Murdered is what happened. Why drag me through the mud about it?
Someone stop that murderer!
Dead as a dodo.
Challenge to a fight to settle the claim on this borough.
I hear you've dealt with Mr. Lynch on your own terms. Now all that stands between you and the Strand are his ever-loyal cronies. Good luck.
This borough belongs to us!
Power to the people!
Rocks! Rocks! It's time to fight! No!
See a warrior in its arms!
Jacob and Evie Frye. And as of this moment, you all work for us.
Better check the back. here to see Mr. Roth.
Weapons?
No, thank you. I've got my own.
You should be on the stage, sir. This way.
Guest has arrived. Come, sit. I've had my eye on you for some time. I find your heroics in battling the great Crawford Starrick quite magnificent.
I've been picking off your soldiers one by one. Doesn't that make you angry?
On the contrary, surprise is a spice of life. Now, Mr. Starrick, that's a different story. I'm drowning in directives, all terribly boring. Let's say we work together and bring him down.
I'm not so sure about that.
My friend, if I fail to provide you with the chance to cause Starrick some pain, well, you can charge into this theater and kill me yourself.
What do you get out of all this?
The chance to have a little fun with the bravest man in London.
You have a deal.
Lewis, my carriage. Shall we? This way. Well, you don't expect me to go alone, do you? Take the reins.
Keep moving.
Driver, to St. Pancras. And don't spare the horses.
I thought you and Starrick would be fighting for the same ends. What happened?
You know, he required my services to train his gang leaders. But the man is dreadful.
You don't say.
Freedom, Jacob. Stealing that is far more than a sin. It denies us our humanity.
Right you are. And St. Pancras will ease our suffering?
The station contains a large shipment of explosives to be dispatched to Starrick and Co.
And you intend to steal it?
There's a train parked inside St. Pancras.
Then I'm to do away with Starrick's merchandise, leaving chaos in my wake?
Why not, Jacob? Why not? As we speak, the up train is headed towards us. That may help you enter the station unseen.
As long as it remains on the tracks.
I'd say good luck, but you don't need it. I shall make certain any reinforcements from Starrick are kept away from the station.
Thank you.
Someday, you blighters will understand that I'm doing this for your own good.
Serves you right for behaving in such a manner, and you get this to me, boy.
Two down. Be ashamed to stop now.
There he is!
Shipment left. Now to find somebody to drive this hunk of metal.
Whatever's going on here, I'm ready for the
need
worst.
Need some help. Time on you! I'll strangle you with your own innards!
I've created too much noise. I'll need to keep a low profile.
Off me. What do you think you're up to?
Hush now, please. Do be quiet, sir. No need to make a fuss.
What do you want from me?
I just need you to keep the engine stoked.
All right, I'll help you. Don't hurt me.
Think of me as another passenger. I just happen to have a rather large blade pointed at your back. So kind as to get up some steam.
will be on his knees in no time. My hat is off to you. Apologies, I must run. Do come see me again.
I didn't know you had a twin sister, Mr. Frye.
Evie Frye, sir. It's a pleasure.
Usually I would reciprocate the sentiment, Miss Frye, but today I'm afraid nothing will bring me pleasure.
What's troubling you, sir?
I am used to people challenging my ideas. In fact, I live for it, the cut and thrust of spirited debate. Lately, however, attacks against my reputation have taken a darker turn. Threats of violence against my person and against my colleagues. I do not wish anyone to be hurt because of my research.
You helped me with Staric syrup. I am in your debt.
We help each other, sir.
My brother and I will make sure that you can continue your work in peace.
What do you know of bones?
I know how much pressure it takes to shatter, snap, or splinter.
What's a German doctor supposed to look like, anyway? Wouldn't hurt to know what the bugger looks like.
Mate, we can see
you. Looks like he's got to screw loose.
It takes all kinds.
If I have to come over there, you'll be sorry!
Quite odd. I wonder what that's about.
Someone should alert you.
Differently.
Your precious cargo for our friend Mr. Darwin.
I wonder what that is.
Just act naturally.
Right. So, how is your father? By which I mean my dear brother Frank, with whom I grew up, of course. Oh, splendid! Wonderful to hear! I'll do my best not to call attention to how remiss he was in forgetting to warn me about the delicate situation which brings me here today.
A needle in a haystack, this is.
Cat over there.
That's easy for you. What
about
over there?
Dr. Schwartz?
Never cross the trail.
Darwin's face is sealed. Goodbye, assassin. I did so enjoy meeting you.
Where do you think you're going?
Now to take this fossil to Darwin.
My heart hasn't stopped pounding. You have it? Wonderful. But where is Dr. Schwartz?
Most likely dead, I'm afraid. He never left Germany. At least I managed to get the fossil back.
Dear Lord, I should tell you I was recently approached by men who sought to purchase all my research on the condition I work only for them. Obviously, I refused. Scientific knowledge cannot be bought. It belongs to everyone. Let these villains do their worst.